Hello friends, my name is Kishan and this is the continuation of my previous video tutorial where we had discussed about the Spring with JDBC module. So here I am going to create a demo project where I will show you how to work with the Spring JDBC template. So right click on the clips and create a new Java project with name Spring with JDBC. Click on the next and finally click on the finish button. So here go to the properties and change the compiler version 1.7 and let's add the Spring dependency jars in our class pass. So go to the library, add library, user library, here is the Spring dependency. Now in this module, in this demo project, we are going to learn how to work with the Spring with JDBC. So here basically we are going to interact with the RDBMS or persistence storage. So here we are going to work with the MySQL databases. So here I have created a Spring with JDBC schema, database schema, and in this schema I am going to create a very simple table. I have executed this DDL query. So table name is employee underscore table and these are the columns like employee ID, name, salary, email and gender. For simplicity, just I have added few columns, but you may add more than that with different data type. And here employee ID I have made auto incremented. These are the column value we will insert from the Java program, but this column will be automatically populated into the databases. So now let's go to the project and here how to install MySQL database and how to install a Toad for MySQL. I'm assuming you guys know very well, so these things I'm leaving up to you, and here we'll mainly focus on the how to work with the Spring with JDBC. So go to the src folder and create a package com.infotech.model and class name I'll give employee and let's add field like private int employee ID, private string employee name, private string email, private double salary. And what else we have in this table? In this table, yeah, we have a 5 columns. We need to include gender as well, right? So private string, you may add some more fields with different data type, but for simplicity I have added this much field only. So right click over here, go to the source and generate setter getters for these fields. So this is the model class we have created. Now let's create a XML file that is called a Spring configuration file. I would give the name bins.xml and we required, this is a blank XML file, we required a XML doc type which we can copy from our existing example. So let's open this project and here we have a configuration file. So let's copy this XML doc type from this project and paste it over here. So we have created configuration file as well. Now let's create an interface is called package name com.infotech.service. This is a service interface. I would give the interface name employee. Employee service. And let's create one more interface is called in package com.infotech.daw. It's a DAW interface. I would give the name employee DAW. DAW stands for data access object. Now this interface, in this interface we are going to declare some API, public abstract void create employee. This is first API, and this guy will take the parameter as employee. So now next API we are going to declare. So basically we are going to perform the CRUD operation. So return type would be employee get employee by ID, and here you need to pass the input parameter as employee ID. This is the second API we have declared. Next return type would be void delete employee by ID. So some specific scenario, if you would like to delete any specific employee information from the data storage, then you can do. Now next API return type I'm giving void. You may choose the return type anything, whatever you want. So update employee email by ID. So here we'll have two input parameter. First is the string new email, and second parameter required to pass employee ID. Now last but not the least, we have a get all employee info. So I would give a list of, this will return you the list of employee, and method name get all employees details. Control Shift O for organize import. So sorry, this is the wrong import. So we need to import from java.util package. So now we are going to create a implementer of this interface, right? So let's right click over here, new, and we are going to create a class, and package DAW IMPL I'm going to give, and class name I would give employee DAW IMPL means implementer of. And now this guy is going to implement interface is called employee DAW. So select this guy, okay, finish. So these are the method we need to override, because our DAW class implements this interface. Now almost similar method we are going to declare in our service layer interface, service interface. So we have a service interface as well. So usually in real project we do not insert data into database directly. So you have a UI, then controller, from controller you make call to the service layer where you do service layer validations, and finally once you do the data messaging, all kind of business kind of validation, then you send the data from service layer to DAW layer. So here we may change method of name like fetch. This is create to add here, get or fetch, you can change method name so that this will look little different. Then delete, keep as it is, no problem. Now or employee info, you can see like this. Now we have a service interface. Now we need to create a class, service IMPL class, which is going to implement this interface. So right click over here, class, and package name service.impl. I'm going to specify here implementer class IMPL. So usually we should follow this naming convention. So employee, this guy is going to implement interface like employee service interface. Now let's create a client program. Just I'm going to create a template first of all, then after we'll complete the rest of the code. com.infotech.client. So here I will give the test client class name as a test, which will have a main method. Now let's first complete this beans.xml. Here, first of all, if you want to interact with the data storage, then in Spring with JDBC, first of all, you need to configure a bean is called data source bean. So bean ID equal to, I'm going to specify data source. And now class you need to keep in your mind. So that class name is driver manager, something is called driver manager data source. So press Control Shift T to search a class in jar file. So driver manager data source, so this is the class. So click on this arrow button so that you will come here and copy qualified name of this class and paste it over here. So this is the bean which is provided by the Spring framework. Then this bean requires some properties value. So those value you can specify like that, property name and value pairs like this. So this bean asks you to supply value for four properties. So first property we have a driver class name. So as we are working with the MySQL database, so we need to add one of the jar which is provided by the MySQL database vendor. So that jar we haven't added yet. So right click on this project, go to project build path, configure build path, and this jar directly I'm going to add in the class path. So I'm not going to define any user defined library for this. If you want, you can add that jar in the Spring Leaf itself, which is our user defined library, but directly you can add as well. So add external jars, and here is that jar, this jar you will have to add. And driver class name you may get from this jar. So expand this jar, and here we have a package is called com.mysql.jdbc. expand this jar and search for the MySQL. So we have a driver class name for different databases, right? So this is the class. So copy qualified name. So this driver class name we need to specify over here. Then you need to specify the database URL. So database URL you need to specify like this: jdbc://localhost:3306 is the port number of MySQL server. And here finally you need to pass the schema name, database schema name, that is Spring with JDBC I have created in MySQL. Now this is the database URL we have supplied. Now database username you need to specify. So username is root in our case, and database password you need to supply as well. Password is root only. So guys, I'm running behind the time, so rest of the things I'm going to continue in the next video tutorial. So to understand Spring with JDBC, please go through my next video tutorial Till then, happy learning.